Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll be demonstrating how to create a spray plan and record a spray using Croptracker. To record a spray, you will need to make sure your chemical and spray information is recorded in Croptracker. To learn more about how to enter chemical and sprayer information, check out the video links in the description. The steps for recording a spray and spray plan are almost identical. The main difference is when you record a spray, Croptracker understands that treatment is a spray that has been applied to your field. When you record a spray plan, you will need to confirm when the spray has been applied for Croptracker to record it as a completed spray. Let's start with creating a spray plan. From the dashboard, you can click the blue New Spray Plan button, or under the Growing drop-down menu at the top of your page, select Record Spray Plan. On the Edit Spray screen, there are four steps you'll need to fill out. Beginning with when and why, fill out the relevant information in the field provided. Many of these fields are optional, but the more you fill in, the more accurate and easy to organize your records will be. For example, creating a relevant title for the event that indicates what the spray was for and where it was applied will make it easier to search for later. The Event Status option does not need to be selected, but can be used to control viewing and editing permissions for this event if you have multiple users on your Croptracker account. For more information on how this works, check out the Knowledge Base link in the description. If you select a saved treatment from a previously created treatment plan, much of the information will be auto-populated. To learn more about creating a treatment plan, check out the video links in the description. When you have filled in the information on this screen, click the Next button. The next step, Where, prompts you to pick the blocks the spray will be applied to. You can pick using the map or the list below by farm, block, or by crop or variety. If you select using variety, Croptracker will assume all blocks with that crop variety will be sprayed. Hit the blue Next button at the bottom of the screen. The third step, What, is where you input your chemical information. You can select one or more chemicals from the drop-down menus and input the amounts you're using. Note that the chemical output rate should not include water. Under the sprayer information, select the pre-calibrated sprayer you will be using from the list. Optionally, you can specify the person who applied the spray and what safety equipment they used. When you've finished, hit the blue Next button at the bottom of the screen. The final step, Confirm, will display the pre-harvest and re-entry intervals. You can choose to be notified by email when they have passed. Review the chemical information displayed to confirm that it is accurate. Optionally, you can include any comments or notes. Press the Save button at the bottom of the screen to finish. After saving, your spray plan will be displayed on your dashboard. To confirm when the spray has been applied, simply press the small arrow button in the right side of the Actions column and select Sprayed. Spray plans that have not been confirmed will not be included in spray reports. To record a new spray, use the blue New Spray button at the top of the dashboard or select Record Spray from the Growing drop-down menu. Recording a spray follows all the same steps as creating a spray plan. When you hit Save, your spray will appear in your dashboard. You can view all your recorded sprays and spray plans from your dashboard, and can easily compile your spray information into many useful reports. To learn more about Croptracker's report function, check out the reports video link. To see how to add a spray on your mobile device, check out the video links in the description. This concludes our video on recording sprays with Croptracker. And as always, thanks for watching!